What is up, people? Welcome back to another episode of Project Ozone 2 Kappa Mode. I hope everybody's doing alright. I'm doing amazing. And today we've got something really cool to do. Like, I mean, something really cool. Something that I actually have never done. And you know it's rare. Something that I've never done. This doesn't make any sense. Let me show you a little bit what's happened here. Since the last episode, I've got like upgraded the researcher with the machine infuser. That's why we needed those. And I just like I saw just after I stopped recording that there was an EMC on it, so I didn't need to look for it. I've also infused the dimensional builder, and I've made a dimlet scrambler, which got used, and a dimlet workbench. To craft workbench. And yes, I did not open that one because I've already started doing stuff. With this thing here, you can get like a rarity, different rarity. And the one I'm looking for is a 6. And as you can see, I've got some already. I've got 2 wither. Like, I'm not gonna do a wither. Like, the wither's so hard to kill in this mod pack that like it's gonna be a suicidal dimension. And it's also a 100 million RF to keep. But yeah, so I've got like molten draconium, which I would like to use, but I'm not sure if I have enough power. I did had 32 solars. I should probably fill the whole thing so that we're sure. And I've got resonant tender. But the one I want of rarity 6 is this one, the dragon dimlet. Yes, yes, the dragon dimlet. It will spawn dragons. And I got everything, and this thing took forever to grab. Oh, actually, I can remove that one. You need to break down with this tool. Let me show you how you do it. Rarity, I'm gonna break down a six. Like, let's grab 2 of those. And let's put them there, and then you extract it, and you have a chance to grab, to get like some of those. And there we go, I've got another one. Nice. That's cool. So with this, let's say like this one, I got liquid. So that's cool. I got also the type, but I had to break down a mob type to get the type. I had to break down to get the advanced energy module. I needed also the 6 because this one is a rarity 6. But if you looked at this, it takes 2 million RF to make, but it takes 50 million to create. So the only thing left is we need to, you know, grab some DNA from the dragon with a syringe. I know it sounds a little bit, you know, crazy in the head to do this, but we can do it because we can just, you know, respawn the dragon. And the way we're going to do that is by using the draconic evolution. I think it's resurrection stone. Oh, I would have thought it would have been there. Resurrection of the dragon, reaper enchant, ritual of draconic resolution. Yeah, so as you can see, that's what we're gonna have to do. So we're gonna need 1 resurrection stone, which is already in the system, ready to be crafted. We'll need 4 charged draconium block, 4 diamond blocks, 4 obsidian, 4 glowstone, and 12 quartz pillar. So in here, I've already got this. I went and killed a bunch of Endermen simply because they give like pearls and they were just easy to get in the end. All right, so bam. I could have used the other one, but I wanted to keep them because I don't have necessarily a lot of those. So I've decided to keep those and just try to go farm. I still have 2. Why are they not stacking? Endermen? Extra planet evolved Enderman. Oh, they're different. Okay. All right. So now that I've got this, I will need some quartz pillars. I need 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. We'll need some diamond blocks. Like so. 1, 2, 3, 4. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 of these. I will need some obsidian. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right. And I think I've got everything. Let's make sure. One resurrection stone, done. Glowstone, done. No, 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 I don't have the glowstone. Glowstone. Start. That's one of the things that I automated. Okay, glowstone done, obsidian done, diamond block done, charged draconian blocks done, quartz pillars done. And then the pillars once, you have to simply recollect the ritual stone. Alright, well, let's go to the end. Okay, and we're gonna put him... let's do it here. Oh, I'm grabbing some of the items. Okay, so there's one thing I need to tell you. Don't press that if you're not ready. So the glowstone in the corners. Okay, and then this is gonna be two. Okay, and then it's gonna be one. That the other one is here. One away from the corners. Like so. If I look, this looks alright. Let's place the four diamond. And the charged draconium. Here, and there. And then, well, we right click. Ow. Oh wow, the sound. Whoa. Oh, he's already there. Okay, well, let's grab the syringe and we need to poke him with it. We need to poke him. He's so quick. No, get back here. Okay, I think I need one more and I'll be fine. Oh, come on, get here. Yes, is it full? Yeah, 100%, okay. And then what we want is this thing here. That's why I'm doing this. Oh, the sound, man. Why is it that loud? Alright, well, we got that, so that's cool. We can go back home. Alright, let's go home. And in here, we can place this one. And there you have it, guys. The Mob Dragon Dimlet. Oh, yeah. All the parts. Dimlet. Constrict a new dimlet out of parts. Constrict. Alright. So in here, we're going to place this. And this is going to give us a flat terrain, a plains. I just placed one just for the heck of it, and a Mob Dragon Dimlet. So that's what I'm going to do. I don't know how much it's going to cost to handle. If it's too much, I'm just going to add more solar panels. It's not a problem. Let's put those in there. Let's put that. This, that. We don't need a tablet anymore. Alright, so we need a dimlet maker. Boom. A boom. Oh man, please work. Please work. I can make another one, so it's not a problem. Dragon store. It costs 2,100,100, guys. That's not how you pronounce numbers. Alright, so let's put him in there. Now it's gonna progress and do its thing. Man, I hope it works. This thing. I can't wait. It's gonna be one shot. Wow, my frames are low. Are you the one making this? Are you the one making my frames go bad? There you have it. Wow, it was! Okay, so this thing is ready to go in. Alright guys, let's go kill some dragon. Just let's go make sure my power is able to handle that before I go in. I went to the wrong level. In and out. It's keeping up. It's keeping up. All right, we're good. Let's go in. All right. I can't wait. I want to kill some dragons. Oh, yes! There's dragons everywhere! So now look at this! 3 hearts! Let's go with 4 hearts! 5 hearts! 6 hearts! So I'm just gonna go flying about and killing a bunch of dragon. And yeah. Oh, this is so great. Oh, and it's also making me some dragon egg. Nice. Oh my god, this is amazing. Alright guys, I'm gonna kill more and I'll bring you guys back. Alright guys, so I was able to get 64 hearts. I got 65 because I already had 1. But I was able to get 64 in less than like 5 minutes. It's a joke. But if you've watched my Sky Block series, you know that at some point I was supposed to show people how to do something. Well, I thought I would do it today. Alright, so the first thing is I've got a lot of things in my inventory. And, well, most of them are going to be used. So I'm going to make something like so. I actually don't 100% remember the way I did it. But I am going to try to remember. Okay, so the thing I remember is I need an interface here. I will need my... I'll remove that. I'll place my tesseract right under. There. Receiving power. And I will put my controller right on top. So now we've got power into the controller. So now we can place some things. Okay. So the next step, I've got some little pictures on the side in case I'm trying to remember exactly what I've done. It was working so well. Okay, so bam, 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 bam here. So that's 4 and we're gonna put annihilation plates in there. So it's gonna be like so. But annihilation plate can only be placed into a storage. So you can't, like, if let's say I wanted to destroy this, it's not gonna destroy it because I didn't say there was a storage anywhere to destroy it. So that's actually something I forgot to do. Do I have storage bus? I do. Nice. Okay, and in here I should have a 1 ender chest. So now let's say I place the ender chest here and I put a storage on side and I do this. Now this one should be able to break it, unless it's just not able to break. Oh, there you go. It broke it and it sent it in there. Simply because it allowed it to go there. Alright. So, in my storage, I should have kept a weakened block. So, 1 awakened block. What I'm going to do is I'm going to whitelist the awakened block right there. That's the only thing I'm going to allow to go. Alright. So I can place that one there. So now, if I place, let's say, this, it's not going to break because it's not an awakened block. So, there we go. Alright, so that is done. The other thing we need is... we're gonna go here, 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 like so. I need to separate. I forgot to put some anchors. I could just use a dance cable, but I don't think I need to. I'm gonna actually remove that one. Place that and place the storage bus. That means I also need to regrab that awakened block. And we can test it by just placing the awaken and make sure that it gets destroyed. There you go. It gets destroyed. Cool. Okay. So the next step for me is I need to place my things on the side like so. All right. And this one is going to be placing blocks. And what are those are going to place? Well, they're going to place charged draconium because that's the block. Charged this one. Cool. So we can go here, tell it to place, and here it's block placement. So it's not just going to drop it. It's going to place it. And if I place, let's say, 1, 2, 3, 4, there we go. It's going to place the blocks and it's going to wait. It's not going to break. What the? Oh! It's breaking it and placing it here. Okay, we're just gonna remove that one. It's kind of driving me nuts. Okay, how did I do that? So these take from storage. This one counts as a storage, so this one tries to place it at the same time. I would have to make two different systems. Yeah. Okay, I know. I know how to do it. All right. So I need to grab some quartz, like so, to grab the power, and then I need an export. An export, normal export bus. I could try to export. The last time I tried to craft with this thing, the thing in the middle just decided to go off. Okay, no, this time it stayed. All right, and then we're gonna put an export bus. No, it's the opposite. This is complicated. I will need this there. We'll remove that. Okay, maybe it's an import I need. Yeah, okay, we'll grab the import. Drop a cable down. Place the import. We'll break it. Place the import. And then we'll have that. There we go. Okay, so now it shouldn't cause the issue simply because, well, it doesn't care. This thing will only input that. So if I place one in there, it's going to import it, but it's not breaking it in a frenzy to do something. So that should work. And if I break one, all right, so I think this is going to work. Cool. So that's the first step. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go and place these. I'm just using these because I want to. There's no real reason. Like so. I'm also gonna put facades and things. All right, so what is going to happen is that you need, if you guys know, is you need to explode the heart to so that these blocks, the awakened, there we go. The awakened blocks actually explodes and transform into an awakened block. So on this side, we are going to do just that. So we are going to need an autonomous activator about here. Yes, which is gonna right click onto a creeper statue. Yes, onto a creeper statue, and I'm not kidding, because the creeper statue creates explosions. And this, I can show it, heart. If I drop a heart without having the magnet, let's go, the heart will go and start waiting for Draconic. Let's grab 16. 16, and then it will go out, and it can reach this block at this distance. And then, when it explodes, it doesn't do any damage, normally. I hope. Come on, explodes. It's going to change the blocks, which are getting destroyed, and sent to our system. So I think you understand a little bit where I'm going with this. So I'm going to continue, and I'm going to bring you guys back to show you the redstone behind it, because there's a big, big, big part of redstone. So I'll be back in a sec. All right, guys. So check it out. So that is the full setup. Logically, I'm going to redo it simply because it doesn't look as good as I want, and also it's off-centered. But I wanted to show you what it does exactly. So you're going to hear it? It pushed me too. I've got a sound muffler because this is loud. All right, let's go at the top because the top is the important part. Well, actually, not really. You've got the interface here that is going to take your charged draconium, which is going to come from this chest here at the top. So your input will go in this chest, and this chest will then distribute everything. Over here, you've got your input chest, which is going to output draconium on that side all the way to the interface. On this side, you will have a draconic cores. On this side, you will have dragon heart. And the reason I've got retrievers is simply because you can set how many you want. So if, let's say, there was 107 in there, it will only grab 16. And if you can see, those are item ducts. They are really important for the fact that they are slow. We don't want the items to go in super quick, because if there's already 16 item and they just left, we don't want it to go in and then go out and get dispensed with the other one. We want to do one at a time. So in here it's going to do one, in here it's going to do 16, and those here are turned off and wait for a redstone signal. This one's gonna output the draconic core. This one's gonna output the heart. It's gonna output straight into the statue. So these are gonna drop, land right here. This one's gonna drop right on there. And I'm just gonna let it explode because it's gonna push me. All right. So in here at the top, I've got a repeater on 8 ticks. So it's just enough to flash once, so the items go, because those are warp. That's why there's power to it. It's warp item ducts, so it's instant. And at the top, we've got a 16 tick, 16 tick that goes into our autonomous activator. You do need to add one of those augments, again, not too expensive, and you do a right click on the statue. So I think that what's left to do is actually test that. So we're gonna grab, I already had some. Well, we're gonna do 2 to make sure that everything works. So like this, draconic heart, and all the heart. Boom, boom, we're gonna do 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so I'm just gonna make sure that I'm not in the middle. Okay, just clicked. All right, so we're gonna place these in there. And as you can see, half of it is gonna go. So right now in here, we've got one dragon out, it's 16 dragon, draconic core. And in here, we've got the 8. So, why is it not outputting? It should be, oh, it's because I already had 4 in there. Sorry, I forgot. So this one just started doing this. It's gonna pull in the hearts, change the blocks. And that's where I wasn't sure how many. Okay, I need to add more. I didn't know about the timing. 20, 30, let's add more. 40 seconds. Is it enough? Yeah, 40 seconds about. So again, when it's gonna click, it's going to drop the other ones. I'm gonna remove those because they're not gonna be needed. There we go, drops again. This one explodes, go up, grabs the draconic core in a second. I just make sure the timing is right. Changes the block. and then they go in your system in a second. Coming. Come on. There we go. 18 blocks. So there you go. Yeah, that works. And this one, timing, boom. Perfect. So yeah, that's the little system. In the back here, I've got like cable covers on the warp so that it activate this, and there's a line of redstone going to this repeater. So if you guys want to see a tutorial, just let me know. I will do one. I promise. If you guys want it, I will do it. It's just that it's really peculiar on what you can use. That's the only thing that is peculiar. 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 Yeah. Because it uses so many different mods together to do that it is hard to create in another environment. But only for Projecto Zone 2 or Sky Factory or mo things that can have those mods, it will work. But yeah, so let me redo this into a more visually pleasing thing, and I'll bring you guys back after. All right, guys, this is more like it. This looks good. This looks amazing, actually. And I also installed something that makes it that it doesn't go boom when there's nothing. Well, let me show you how it works first. Well, let me show you how things are done, which most of it is done behind. And this might change to this coming here and this going on the side, just so it's not visible like as an angle. But I changed the timing in the back. So now, like, this is going to the autonomous activator. This is going to the top. At the top, the chest is a comparator coming out on an inverter to the timer. So if there's nothing in the chest, this thing won't work. So currently, we're simply going to. As you can see, it just started. What I'm going to do is place the out there. And simply go like this. All right, so now that means I can do this, and now it's not visible. That's the important part. It's not visible. Also, one thing I could do would be to do something like so. Same thing on the other side. And maybe. You know, going. So I'm using all the blocks I have. I don't have like change of those wither blocks. All right, there we go. So now it looks okay. You can't see the back from either side. Oh, it. What? Why did it activate? It shouldn't be activating because there's no items. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I kind of broke the block over there. There we go. So now it's back to normal. Okay, so at the top, I decided to pass this cable from all the way to the bottom to all the way to the top, which I forgot to replace because I wanted to show you on the other side. So now I move the tesseract there so it's not visible. I place facades everywhere so it's not visible from the front. Everything is connected the same way, works the same way, just a lot prettier. And at the bottom, again, this the autonomous activator, sound muffler, everything's connected here. This is connected with the export. I just found out that like I don't really need this. I don't really need the ME controller, but it's this or an energy acceptor. And I had controller, I don't have any energy acceptor. So all right. The only thing I haven't done is finding a way to get there. I need a way to input into there, into that block. So it's probably going to come from this side, like an ender chest place here with a cable going down, or probably an ender chest one block higher so I can put a facade there. Yeah. But all right, let's test this. So in my inventory, I've got my 64. I crafted a bunch. I'm just gonna place 32 in there. Dragon heart. Let's grab two. And charged, we need four more. All right, so we're gonna place everything in that chest. Oh wait, did I do my connections here? I forgot to see 1 and 16. All right, yes, we can do that. Boom, boom, and boom. Come on, you gotta place faster. Okay, there you go, it's placed. So I found out that like the explosions are not damaged. They don't do any damage. So it isn't a bad thing to have the explosion. And I thought this looks okay. This looks not bad, except like currently like I've got a hole over there, but I'm gonna put the ender chest and I'm probably gonna put one here. And eventually I wanna place another like glass in front. All right, so the 40s, the only thing that is sad is that it needs to wait 40 seconds first to start your first one, because it needs to start the clock. It doesn't like start it in a go. Oh no, what happened there? Oh, it's okay. I grabbed all the things. For some reason, the heart didn't go at the right place. Put these back. Oh, it's true. I can't see it from there. This thing is on 16, this thing's on 8. That's what it was. Alright, let's see for the second one. It is, you know, a little long waiting the 40 seconds just to test, but that's how it is. I haven't tested again! It didn't turn it on. Why? Give me those. I think I'm gonna add another repeater for this little fella. I'm gonna add one that has like the same amount. Maybe just 8. Like so. So it's just gonna slow it down a tiny bit. Let's place those in there. And we'll see. You gotta look at your timing, because the timing is the most important thing. So if your timing is not right, there you go. There we go, now it's working. Goes up. Gonna drain this. Gonna change those. Oh man, this is working. Nice! Nice! Come on, change. And I also wanna see the timing. It's gonna change, all right? They disappear. The other block should appear. And 3, 2, 1. They drop? No. A little bit. Come on. There we go. Explodes. And it goes in. Perfect. That means that now we're going to be able, I just need to automate the making draconic core and we'll be fine. This is amazing, guys. So I seriously, if you guys want a tutorial, like I said, just ask me and I'll make one. I'm probably gonna make one even if you don't ask. But yeah, guys, that is going to be it for today. So I do hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, don't forget to leave a like. If you really loved it, don't forget to subscribe. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.